Hi friends, welcome to next tutorials. So in this next tutorial in this year, we'll discuss that next tutorial is custom list. So how we can deal with this custom list means like a list view with one image and one text view, or two text views with one image, like our contacts view, how we can deal. So that we will see here. For that, first I'll create one project from here. So I'm creating this name as a custom. So list, I'm creating this project name as a custom list. So with this list, once we create this one, we'll discuss what is how we are designing that. So that we will show here. So this is the this. Now while creating the project, we'll observe how is the view we are expecting this. Now here I'm expecting the view like this. So this is my layout. So in this layout, see, so here first I'm expecting this is the image, side of the image I'm expecting here one text and two text, like this. Each row I'm expecting like this, again here like this. I'm expecting the each row should be like this. Means now we'll deal with this one image plus two text views. Like same, if you want, you can elaborate that same concept for more text views, more image views. That's the same process. So for that, here first in this XML file, so directly first I'll add as usually how we are dealing with this normal list view, the same kind of here. So first I'll create here this list view. So here for before getting this list view, I want to change this my regular layout, that is a linear layout. So here I'll change my flexible layout, linear layout. So I'm removing this one. So here I'm adding this list view. So basic list view I'm adding here. So match parent, both I give you some match and match. So just I'm giving you here SS ID, that is a list. So this basic is done. So now I'll enter into this Java. So in this Java, so here as usually I'm declaring this list view. So list view, just I'm defining this list view. So list view, so something list. Then I need to identify as usually, so list view equal to find view by ID. So just I'm identifying that based on the ID. So this we call as a initialization list. So list initialization is done. So after this, here, see, now here what is my view? Here my view should be one image plus two arrays. So I need here total three arrays. So here I'm creating this three arrays. One is a string, so contacts name. So I'm putting as this contacts names. So just I'm putting this as a contacts names. So this is array declaration. So in this I'll add here few details like AAA, this is the first person name, BBB, second person name, third person name, and the fourth person name, like this. I'll add few details into this. So then after this, in this next same string, so here I'm creating one more array, that is the contact. So contact numbers. So I'm sharing this next as a numbers. So this is also one array. So in this I'm creating here 1, 2, 3. So 3, 4, 5. So then 4, 5, 6. Must and should array's length should be equal. So just I put like this. So the next I'm putting some images for those respective. So for images I'm creating here integer array. So int. So contact image, so I'm creating here contact image. So contact image, so contact images, so contact images, then array. So then it should be array in declaration. Then in this, so now in this I need to add images. So if you want to add the images, so here I'll go to here my drawable folder. So on the drawable folder, right click on drawable folder. So from I want to use some default icons from here. So then I'll go to from the right click new resource in the new on that image asset. So from the image asset, so here I can pick some values here in the SE launcher. So I'll put this first one as a AAA. So from here I'm selecting few images from here. So I'm selecting this image from here. So just I want to change that color as well. So I change this color. So I'm finished this. Like this, I create total 4 images. So next image asset, same here, in place of the AA, I'll go with a different name. So BBP. So then I'll select here one more image, like this image I select, and click on the finish. So second image is ready, and this next I'll go with this third image. So from here I can go with this third image. So that third image should be CCC. So from here I'm selecting this, and I select one more image. So third image. So total 3 images ready. So next I need one more last image. So that last image also I pick from here, that is DDT. So then from here, by clicking on this, I'm changing this image. So like total I gathered 4 images. Now here I'll add those 4 images. See, AAA BBB is copied here. So I'll add here dot drawable dot this. So because of that, here just we are passing the ID, because of that is the ID reason only. Here I'm taking this as a integer array. So remaining two are the directly we are giving the string values. So because of that, we taken that as a string. Then r dot drawable dot. So then DDT. So done. These all are the done. So then now after this, here as usually, like normal list view, here we use array adapter, but for this, instead of the array adapter, directly we'll deal with this list adapter dot set adapter. So directly we are setting the adapter here. So I'm setting adapter. So here, from here, I'm creating this new adapter, that is I'm giving the name as a custom adapter. This is user defined. You can type anything on this. So I'm going with this. So custom adapter. In this, I'm passing total. One is the context. So that is our context is this main activity dot this. I'm passing our context. So after the context, here I'm passing what are the arrays are there. So those array resources. First one is here contact names. So I'm going with this contact names. Second one is with contacts contacts images, and the third is this contacts numbers. So I'm sharing total 3. So these values I'm sharing from here. So now with this name, you can create one class by clicking the Alt Enter. Here we are getting the two options, create a class. So I'm clicking on the create a class. So class is created. So class is created. So this class, which came with the default, it came with this implements list adapter. But I don't need this implement list adapter. So I want to go with this as the with extends base adapter. So just I'm changing this as the extends base adapter. So it is showing this. Why I came with this means base adapter has total here implemented methods. Those implemented methods are here. This see, one is a get count, one is a item, one is the item ID, that last one is the view. So total it has 4 implemented methods. So it will come. So along with this, here one constructor is created. That constructor is what we are passing the values from there. Those we are coming here. This see, there we are passing one context comma this. So we need to localize this first step in this. We need to localize this means if you want to use these values here, we need to localize this. So here I'm localizing this. So here what I'm doing here is this name string. I'm creating this one. So just I'm treating this as a names. So then this I'm treating as images. So just I'm treating this as a images. So the next last one I'm treating as a numbers. So this is I'm treating as a numbers. So here these are the 3 arrays. So now along with those, we need the context, because this is we are in the now in the child class. So we can't access that main activity does here directly as a context. Because of that, I'm localizing here. So first I'll map with this context equal to, so here main activity. See, once I added this main activity, now main activity should be whatever the main activity context is that I can access with this name. Like same here I can access the next, it should be here names. So names equal to here contact names, then images, then images equal to here contact images, then last, so that should be numbers. So numbers equal to So your contact numbers. So like this, we can assign these values like this. So once this assign these values here like this, so now here comes into here, then here you can put this return type as, so here just count. So here this count is any of the array name, you can take any of the array name dot length, it should be here giving this length. So but here possibility is there, you can write like this also, contacts is equal to, so images dot length also, this is also one array, because every array should be here now equalized, so because of that you can deal with any of this numbers dot length, any of this, okay. But here I'm commenting these two, why? Because we are using one, so any of either you can comment one and you can use remaining any of this. And the next year only this we are passing only the position here and item also, this is also based on the position, so just we are passing in these two cases the position and position only. So then after this position and position, here last will come this last, so here this comma is missed, so here will come with this. Now in this last, that is the view. So in this view, here we are dealing with this here view, we are creating some view here. I'm using the new concept, that is this layout inflator. So layout inflator is nothing but it should replace the new view with a different view. So that is here layout inflator. So inflator, so here I am writing this new inflator. So this is already which is defined in our system, so because of that it is a system service, directly we can get as a get system service. But we are now in the indirect class, so because of that if we need to deal with here with based on the context, so context dot get system service. See, here now we are getting that system service. So in the system service, we are here in the system service, what we are adding, this is the based on the context we need to add, so that is the context dot, so context dot get layout inflator service. So this layout inflator service we are adding this because I want to replace this each and every line of view, it should be with this different view. So this is expecting typecasting also, we need to add the typecasting also. So once this typecasting is done, so then it should be this. So then here we need to create some view, that view I'm creating some new view here. So something row view, I'm creating this each and every row view. So this view we can map with this inflator, so layout inflator. So layout inflator dot inflate, see means what we define here dot inflate, in this we can write here r dot layout dot. So here we can create some new layout, that is a custom. So from here this, there is no secondary view, that should be the always, it should be the false. So now once it is created, immediately you can give this as a row view. So then whatever the code we are writing, that you can write in between. But here initially you can create one XML file. So I'm creating this, is this one XML file. So this XML file which we create with some layout. So in this layout, I'm creating with this one linear layout or something linear layout, because I'm expecting the view like this. So side by side. So this orientation, I'm taking the orientation as the horizontal. So then first I'll take one image view into this, so image view, so I'll take this as a image view. So image view is this match wrap content and wrap content. So then here I'll take this image view, some ID for this image view IV. So for our reference purpose, here I'll put something on this. So our reference purpose, I'll put some sample image also. So I'll put this SRC so that we can access from something image. Just I'm showing this view. So just preview, you can see this image view should be here. It should be first image view. Then side of this image, I want to arrange two text views. So two text views should be, we need to add in this horizontal manner, because vertical manner, because of that I'm taking one more layout, that is a match parent wrap content. For this, I'm taking the orientation as vertical. So now within this layout, I'll take two text views. So one is the one text view. So text view, then this text view as wrap content, then some ID. So ID I'm giving you as a TV. Then some text or understandable, some text I'm giving you, that is the something text. So then here for this, I'll give you some text size also, text size and color. So I'll give you color as a color accent. So then I'll give you this text size of this. like your 25 SP, I'm giving you the text size. So same way I can design one more this, so second that one. So here I can create one more this, I copy and paste, I can create this second. So this I put this DB1. See, this is the view which we are expecting this as output. So this here we created like this. So now this is ready. So from here, so from here this is ready. So from here, so after this, now whatever the elements we find out there, so that you can add here now. So that you can add here. So means we need to identify the text view. So I'm identifying the text view equal to T1 equal. So here we are identifying that. So but directly normally we outside we have find out find view by ID, but here we can't identify like that based on this row view, because this is mapped with this row view. So because of that row view, we need to identify here find view by ID, that is R dot ID dot. Here first one should be this is the TV, and the same second one. So second one should be here, that is us in place of the TV, it should be this. So this is the T2, then it should be here, this is the TV1. So then last we need to identify, that is the image. So image view IV equal to row view dot find view by ID. So here we are adding this find view by ID for that. So find view by ID, that is R dot ID dot. So that is the IV. So image view done. So then finally here we need to add last, it should be here. For this we need to add, so T1 dot set text. So we are setting the text. So but where we can set the text? So for the T1 I want to set the name. So the names I am accessing from this array. So here we need to access that array name here. So names here based on the position. So here position by position we are getting the values here into this. The name same T2 dot set text. Here this is for this T2 we are arranging the numbers. So numbers. So here we can give this numbers of position. So we are giving with the position. Then last it should be here IV image view, that we are setting this image view. So set image resource. So that is also we are getting from images dot. So images of here also images of position. So now this view is created. So just we'll run this one and we'll see this output. Now we will get that view here. What we are getting this view, that view should be we get like this. What we are expecting now, one image side of that remaining two text views. So that is the view we will get now here. So after this, we'll apply the listener for this and we'll observe how this listener will also perform the action for this. So this concept is very, very important now, because depends on this only. Lot of views should be there in this next level of this. This is very, very important view for us. We need to create for this better. If you understand this complete full concept, you need to go with advanced topics. Easily you can build this advanced views based on the same view. So it is now almost it should be done this for this. While running this, here I'll apply the listener also. See here, if I want directly from the every, means for each row, if I have the single action, so directly I can apply here set on click listener, which we applied the previously this set on click listener, on item click listener. So new on item click listener, just I'll put some toast here for this position, we call the position. So just I'm putting this toast here. I'll apply this position. Just we'll observe the position, means listener is applying or not. Just we'll observe here. So once just a minute, it is still running. So once it is run, we'll observe both. So then after that we'll go with the each item. The next listener should be here. If I click the one image, I need a different, I'm expecting different action. If I click on this text, I'm expecting different action. So that also we'll observe now. Once it is done, that also we'll observe now. See, this is the view now like this. So there is no action because we not applied previously, that is the view. So for this image size also, I need this one big size. So it is normal now, normal size because of the this. So here I'll put this image size is like 100 dp by 100 dp, like I'll apply with a good structure. So now it should be like better, we can put like 80 dp by 80 dp, so that it should be some attractiveness, it will come this with image. So now we apply the listener also. The listener we applied now in this main activity, that should be for complete row, it should perform the same, means if I click here, if I click here, it should perform the same action. See, now it should be attractive. See, if I click here, 0, if I click here, 0, if I click, wherever I click, it is giving the same. But I don't need like this. If I click the image, I'm expecting some. If I'm clicking the text, I'm expecting some different action. So that time, you can comment this and you can go to adapter. Here, you can apply the listener. So here, I'm expecting the listener for IV, for image, IV dot set on click listener, because it is filter outing the position only, it will call at a time only one active one action. So because of that we are applying this. So toast, so just I'm applying the toast. So in this, just I'm calling the position only, just we here also will observe this position, just I'm observing the position. Then next, same, if you want you can apply this tv1. So for the text view 1, I'm applying this, so that is the t1. So t1 dot set on click listener. So set on click listener, new on click listener. So new on click listener. So here also I'll put this, so that is this toast. So toast, here also I'm calling the same position. So just we'll observe that one. Here we'll apply, here before this I'll put this t of position, so I of position. So like image I will come, it will come as a image 0, here it will come as a text 0, like this. Just we, our identification purpose, just I changed that one. See, now I'm clicking on this image I0. If I'm clicking this name TV0, I3 TV3, like this, it should be this. So this is about this custom list view. So this is very, very important. So thank you for listening this. Thank you.